And now the heart of it all, the Google Analytics checklist that we will use to go through this course, and you can find it in the resource section and just click on that link and you'll be led right through to this Google document. It's on Google Docs because then I will be able to refine it and develop it further over the months to come. So once you have clicked on this link, you will see this spreadsheet, which is in Google Drive, so we can also update it later. And this is basically our Google Analytics setup checklist that we'll go through in this course. And we'll go through it point by point. And once you open this document, this is protected, only accessible from my account. So what you need to do is click on File and then make a copy. And once you have made a copy, you'll be able to edit your own version of this document. So now that we have made a copy, you can rename this checklist to the client that you have and put in the right company details and the right website. And then you can go through this checklist, and it's pretty self-explanatory. Is the account setup done? And you can choose here the two options. No, it's not done, or it's done, or it's not applicable to this current situation or this account, so you didn't set it up. And in the middle here, you find the recommendation and best practices that we go through in this course. Now, some are very self-explanatory, but just for reference, I put them down in this sheet as well. And you can go through the list. It's not a very long list, but later in the resource section, we'll actually expand this list a little bit more in order to find different lists for different industries. Now you can take this list as it is and go ahead and print it. So you'll be able to print this sheet onto a page and then give it over to your client. If you don't want your client to see these best practices, you can actually go ahead and mark this row and hide this column. And that way you have a very lean list here, and you can just shoot that over as a document or expand it as you want to give your client more information. So now that we have this list ready, we can go ahead and go through the different points here to set up Google Analytics correctly.